The time has come. I have finally finished our next project, and I wanted to thank Atif Bashir. You were the first to guess what the project was going to be. Niranjan Pandey, you came in second place. I want to thank everybody for participating and all of the guesses that you guys sent me. I really appreciate you guys for participating. That was kind of fun for me. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, so we have here an e-commerce website. I'm calling it Coder Shop. There's a lot of dummy text. The styling isn't great, but it does get the job done. So we have some categories here. If you click one, it'll take us over to a page where we just click the kids category. So we landed on the shop page where the category is kids, and this is all the kids stuff. Okay, we also have women's. We have just four different categories. I wanted to keep it as simple as possible. We are also using an Algolia search. So here, let's say we type in kids. You see we have a nice little drop down where you can tab through it. It'll take us to that item, okay, where we have the name, SKU, we have the quantity, the price, just some stylistic things that I put here. There's nothing really in there. I wasn't sure about making a image slider or something. I really wasn't sure what to do with the space, so I just looped over the image at the for this little thing down here. But we do have suggested items based on search, and if you click one, it'll go to whatever that item is. This here, you can see you can click any quantity, and this is listed by how much is actually in the database. So for every item will have a different quantity. Okay, because we did the way that I seeded the database, it was random. So let's say we wanted three of this hoodie here, and we click add to cart. Okay, we're using Sweet Alert. I think that's Sweet Alert to give us a little message. Then it takes us to a cart where it says we have three items in cart. We have a small display of the item. We have some buttons here. So if we wanted to save this one for later, okay, we put it in the three items save for later section. And we also have a move to cart. I'll probably put some highlighting on that later. A lot of this styling stuff I just did very basically. We can also change the quantity right in the cart. Five items save for later, and we can send this back to the cart. Okay, the other thing over here on the right, and we have Sweet Alert for that. The other thing we have here on the right are the totals. So this is the total of the purchase before tax and discount. We have the subtotals. Okay, shipping is free because, hey, why not? The estimated tax is $18.34, but I'm giving it a tax rate of $8.48. Let's see, and down here we also have coupons. So let's use one. This one is going to be a $20 off coupon, and you can see now we have a slot for the coupon code, and the $20 off. Okay, and now that little promo code box is gone. You can click the X. Now that's gone, and now we have this back again. So let's go ahead and add one more item into the cart so that we can check for quantities. So you see here, we have less than five items for this item. We only have one. And so if we were to put it in the cart and purchase it, it's actually gonna remove it from the database. We take a look at the database, we see that that item, this is the first item, only has one. Let's go ahead, add it to cart. Okay, and now we're going to go ahead and check out. Now, as you see here, we have the option to either log in or we can check out as a guest. So I'm going to go ahead and log in because it will work the same regardless if we're logged in or not. Okay, and then we're redirected to the checkout page and all of our credentials are filled in. Now, if we were just a guest, we would be sent to a different checkout page and none of this would be filled out. So let's go ahead and enter in a name, and then we are using Stripe as our payment method. So for Stripe, the card number that works for testing is a bunch of 424s and enter. Okay, so now we're redirected to a confirmation page. It's a confirmation component so that we don't have to authenticate another page. So we have our confirmation number here. You see the item, the name of the item, the quantity, the price, and down below you have the subtotal, tax total, and if we had a discount, that would be displayed here as well. One of the other features about this page is that you can go ahead and print whatever you want to print, and we did some styling to kind of fix that, the normal default print settings up here. So we're not going to print, but we can cancel. Now, because we are using Stripe, we have our user and our purchase all brought into the Stripe website. So we have the customer, we have, it says coder shop, we have an amount, fee, basic stuff that you would see on a back-end receipt. We have the email, the address, basically it was a successful purchase. So there's a confirmation number, you see the product information, the count, we don't have any discount, just basic stuff. The other thing that that did was, since we printed a confirmation, okay, and we're logged in, we also received the email version of it, the PDF form. Okay, you've purchased our swag, blah, blah, blah. We've attached this invoice to this email and we've attached it right here. You can go ahead and open it up and basically you can print it anywhere you want to print it. Let's go ahead and do that and see what that looks like. I'll put this in the desktop. Okay, so just like a regular PDF, go ahead and open it. And now you can see the invoice. This is going to be sent to the customer if they are a customer within our database or they are a guest. Everyone is going to get this confirmation in their email. The benefit of having this set up this way is that if you are an authenticated user, you'll be able to look at it no matter where you want. So let's go see what that looks like. If we head over to the dashboard, I've set this up so that this now edit profile links to the user so that the user can update or change whatever information they want. This is the default that came with our installation. The only thing that I added extra were the fields for the address. That's the only thing that I added extra to the registration. If you click the orders tab, you'll see that this is our most recent order with the total. It gives you the date, it shows you the items, and you'll get this for every purchase that you make, and it's only for you as a customer. There's pagination on it. You can go back as far as whenever. Let's take a look at the most recent one. It has our order number, which is also our confirmation number. If we click view invoice, we'll be taken to this page where you can see our confirmation is in the URL, and it's also right up here. What we can do here is click print invoice. This is done with a special package that we're going to be trying out. I was tinkering with some other packages. So this is the invoice for the user. It has the serial number. We've added our coder shop. We've customized it. We have a seller, the buyer. You have the buyer's address, the information, everything that you would see within an invoice. And then you'll be able to print or save it as a PDF or do whatever you want with it. But if you are an authenticated user, you will always have access to this within the actual app. If you're not, then you will have access to it from your email, which is not directly linked within the app. Hope that makes sense. I'm going to leave it there. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.